Looks like we're taking the long way down. Or should I say the short way? What's going on, guys? LCG here, and I am here to kick off a brand new game that I am entirely way too excited to be playing. This is Ghost Recon Wildlands. You'll see I'm just now kicking off a first round of this game. So I have played briefly, just so I could have a feel for how the gameplay is, and it is absolutely incredible. I'm not even gonna lie. Alright, let's light brown. I want a shaved head. I want a mustache. I got black hair. Oh, facial hair. No. We got the chevron. That's the only authorized military facial hair that I'm aware of. And we're not going to do any of these crazy things. Appearance. Clothes. Can we make them super cool and just put them in jeans? We sure will. And nice old pair of work boots, because this is a working man. Now, we don't want a ghillie suit. Those are kind of silly. Accessories. Let's do the ballistic M-frames, because safety is priority. Alright, we're done here. Let's get into the game. And just as normal, I'm going to play it on regular, and I will let the story mode play through, because that's very important to me, is getting a feel for the immersion created by the game. So, I think that's where this is going to be going right now.
The agent they murdered. You knew him?
He was a friend of mine.
Sorry for your loss.
I could say it comes with a job, but it doesn't get any easier.
No, it doesn't. Guess you've been down here a while?
I've been living as Karen Bowman, international aid worker, for just about 5 years. Means living rough, but as a cover, it gets me out and about.
At least it comes with a chopper.
How'd you get in country?
I flew in business class from Manaus.
Hey, I'm refreshed and ready for work, right? I just hitched rides from Barranco, Peru. How about you?
I got on board a bus in Huy, Argentina, and drank all the way to Villazón. Nobody wants to deal with a drunk on the bus.
That explains why you smell like ass.
I've heard rumors about you guys. I was a rookie field officer in Moscow when the coup went down. There was talk you were involved?
Nah, it must have been someone else. We were never there.
It's not every day you get to meet an urban legend in the flesh.
Huh, you should tell that to my kid. Maybe he'd listen when I tell him to take the trash out.
Is it hard being someone who doesn't officially exist?
You tell me, Karen Bowman, international aid worker.
I'm sure you've seen the horrible, fucked up shit humans are capable of when there are zero repercussions. But let me tell you right now, no matter how you compartmentalize, how you desensitize, you can't prepare for El Sueño. He's got a religious streak that rates pretty close to delusional. He's taken vows of poverty, chastity. If he's not in it for the chocha or the money, he's in it for the power. This joint task force is CIA, DEA, JSOC. I'm your resident spook for this ride. Welcome to Operation Kingslayer.
Our briefing said there'd be a contingent of locals.
The Qatar is 26. They're a group of rebels who've been giving Unidad and Santa Blanca some resistance. We'll meet their leader, Pac Katari, soon as we touch down. Bolivians have a long history of hating us Yankees, but this time, let's hope the enemy of my enemy will be my friend. But don't turn your back on him. I'm not going to.
Soldiers, this is the help you promised, that Sandoval promised? A single Yankee died, so you send a handful of soldiers. Hundreds of Bolivians have died from Santa Blanca's bullets. Where will my hundreds of soldiers come from?
As Americans, we aren't here, remember? These soldiers are the best covert ops team our country has to offer. With their help, you won't need hundreds of soldiers.
Are you familiar with the word Huber, Senora Bowman?
Meet Pac Katari, leader of the resistance group Kataris 26. We will be working with the rebels to destabilize Santa Blanca's organization. They've been fighting Santa Blanca and corrupt Bolivian officials for nearly 6 years now. We'll need to coordinate targets.
There's no time for this. We have information on Amaru's whereabouts.
Amaru? You found him? Amaru is one of the founders of the Kataris 26.
More than that, her group is founded on his ideas. Without his theories of an agrarian proletariat, there would be no organized resistance against Santa Blanca and the corruption in our government. Amaru must be saved. If you were to assist my people, it would do much to earn my confidence.
Where is he?
We do not know exactly. We know he is in this province and that there is a Santa Blanca lieutenant who knows where he is.
I'll put a call into the activity, see if they can dig more intel out of the airwaves. Start looking for that lieutenant and keep me informed of everything via sat phone. Good hunting.
Saving Amaru is important to our cause, Yankee. Make sure you don't kill the Santa Blanca lieutenant before you get the chance to ask him questions.
Alright guys, so that should be the end of all the intro cinematics. I'm gonna warn you guys ahead of time, the language in this game will get a little edgy at times. There will be some mature speak, and I will likely get a little rambunctious and use some terminology that's not typical to my channel. Okay, I'm sorry if that's not really your style, but that's the way this is going to be run. As such, I also want to point out that this game is very graphics intensive. Let me do something with the audio here. Go ahead and cut this down a bit.
All right, let's roll.
All right, so we're going to kick this off. And hopefully they'll give us some directions along the way, baby, because we are taking off in this truck. I'm going to run these episodes a little bit differently, okay? I'll probably do a bit more of a montage. Wait a minute. Was I supposed to talk to somebody up here? Maybe Pac Katari? Did I already skip something? And I'm back! Come on, guys. Get in here. Move it, move it, move it. So as you guys can tell, we're in Bolivia and we are helping to track down and take out some cartel members assisting... Alright, looks like we're taking the long way down. Or should I say the short way? Yeah, let's see what we can come across down here. We're doing a little bit of off-roading, boys. And girls. And squirrels. Look at that.
Cardinal actually believes his own bullshit about the cartel.
Why not?
Because they torture and kill innocent people. Hey, we'll go down
here. Alright, so in the bottom right hand corner there, you can see where we're supposed to be going. I think I went way out of the way with my little expedition in this little jeep here. So, I'm going to follow this trail that they have so kindly provided. And, I will bring you guys back when we're getting ready to hit that mission, all right? So everybody sit tight. Right, we're back, and we're coming up on our first mission here. So you might have noticed that I pretty much went all in right off the bat, right? Shooting over hills and tumbling around and stuff. That's very much not my play style. You'll see here very quickly that I actually, I play very cautiously in most games like this. So we're 300 meters out here. I'm going to start poking around a little bit using the UAV that's provided to us. And up there is where we gotta go. And I don't really see any high ground. There's an equivalent high ground right here, it looks like. It's about the same height, but I don't think we're gonna be able to get up there. Not easily, at least. And, yep, that's an enemy. I love how this game marks enemies for you so that you can later target them with your the squad that you're with.
Deploying drone.
Let's go ahead and send this drone up and get a feel for whatever we can see.
There's one. Tango.
Is there anybody else over here? Is this...
Moving to position.
Yep, there we go.
Call the shot.
And what's beautiful about this game, all right? You ready? Watch this. I'm getting out of range. Oop. I think I see somebody there. Oh, you know what? Let's just take him down. Thank you very much for the sync shot. And then there's a tutorial on Recon. Use Z to use the drone, B for binoculars. We're not going to be using the binoculars so much just yet. And we already have our suppressor on because we like to run in stealth. That's how we do. Good clear shot anywhere from over here. The synchronized shot is what I just used. So we'll go ahead and dismiss that for now. Get this UAV back up. Guy's playing soccer. He's just chilling on his little bench. We got.
And baby makes three.
One. There's our
that
target. Anybody up here? We're getting out of range. Oop! There's some guys down
spotted
there.
One with submachine guns.
We're gonna sink him. Bring the drone down.
Say the word.
And I'm going to take the shot on this guy.
That's a kill.
Two down. Try to get inside here. Then we'll zip the drone out one more time. Make sure we only have these last two. There we go. Woo! Yep, that's not a rendering issue, boys. That's the game. That's on purpose. We don't want to spook him.
Ready to fire.
We're going to try to wait for him to turn around. Go ahead and shoot. Thank you.
That's one less bad guy.
Man, this game is absolutely incredible. I love the tactical feel of this. I really do. I'd like to take that shot on him, but I don't feel comfortable with it just yet. What's this bozo doing over here? If we can get a good interrogation on him without anybody else seeing us, that would be fantastic.
Ready to engage.
Silencio.
Tango down.
Marche.
There we go. We're gonna do our interrogation right here on
you
site.
You answer my questions, or I put a bullet in your gut and leave you to die in your own shit. ¿Lo entiendes?
Chill the fuck up, cabrón. What do you want?
Amaru, where can I find him?
You serious? That's what this is about? Sure thing. He's at Atoya Farm. Go on. Then you can see what we do to people who fuck with us. People like you.
Yeah, good work, Bozo.
Amaru's an old man. He's not gonna last long under torture.
Shit, if they've been working on him for a while, there's a good chance he's already dead.
Maybe, now, maybe here's the thing. We can just boogie on over there, or we can clear this stuff out, right? I want to clear this stuff out.
There's too much riding on this.
Because what we can do is we can go in, we can tag equipment for the rebels to come pick up, and that gives us experience. And you might be thinking, oh, what does that really matter? Who cares if you get experience? Yeah, you'll see in a little bit. And there's also a lot of stuff that can be looted.
Cartel isn't going to wait around for us to track down
camps
and rescue Amaru.
Are there any vehicles coming in that are questionable? Yeah, that one right there. Bat tree. Good. All right. Unfortunately, I only have one sync shot right now.
Ready. Call the shot.
But we'll be able to bump that up here soon. We got four guys at this one camp. How hard can this be, right?
Good to go. I'm engaging Tango.
He's history.
Bam! Bam! That's what it's about. Now, let's get the hell down out of here. ¿Qué pasó? There's stuff back up top side we gotta get. So once I clear this out, I'm gonna cut, go tag that equipment, and then we'll go from there.
Say the word.
That's a kill.
Bam, two down. All right, camp clear. Let's get in here and start tagging things. See this stuff? That's what we gotta tag.
These supplies will buy us a lot of goodwill from the rebels.
Goodwill from the rebels is great, but more importantly, we get experience.
Sueño, the Sicarios have found the escaped prisoner in the village of Culta.
What a wonderful name for a town. They were protecting him.
See, the village is known to Unidad as a haven for rebels.
Why do these rebels even bother? Kill them all. The whole village. Visit divine wrath upon Culta and wipe it off the face of the earth.
Claro, al rato.
You see that? They just want to wipe whole villages off the face of the planet. This is what happens when you let drug wars go on, people. Either make them legal, or make them disappear. Take your pick. Alright guys, it looks like this is the last container that we're going to be able to tag for this area, which is great. We're going to head on over to Free Amaru. I will see everybody there. One thing I've never done in this game is I've never shot an animal. Let's see what happens. Whoop. Maybe nothing. Oh. Or maybe something. That's crazy. Alright guys, what you're about to see here is the bane of my existence. Because I get sidetracked by this stuff every single time I play this game. See this?
Cartel soldiers up ahead. I try to get around them,
yep.
Deal with them head on.
I love that. I love that they'll just park along the side of the road. We can pull up, gun them down from a vehicle, and then hop back in and take off. Alright guys, here we are again. We're about 300 meters from our target. Parked on a back road. We're going in on foot. Alright everybody, here's our picture. Here's what we got. Whoop. Turns out our drone died already. I'm gonna hop up here in a second so you guys can get a better picture of what we're looking at. Let me throw the drone back up real quick. In order of priority, We have Amaru inside with no captains outside. Everybody else is just a meat shield. We will go ahead and sink that guy. And I'm going to try to get these two.
Ready. Call the shot.
At my own pace. What we'll do is we'll come around to the cornfield here. Look at the physics there. The corn stalks bend clear over.
Hey, we got a narco. Inside the barn. Take a look.
Beautiful. You're IDing more people for me. But now we got goats making noise.
Firing. He's gone.
Brain blaster. Might be able to come right in the back here. Oh, whoop. I'm gonna see what that looks like as far as possibilities go. Might be able to do it without even taking down any more people. Alright, here we go.
That's a kill.
We're good. Tango knows somebody's got a bead on him.
Okay, it looks like we might need to draw some people in. Whoop, should've reloaded that one. There. That wasn't so bad, was it?
Coming up on a Toyo farm. Remember, a lot of these Sicarios are ex-military.
ID your targets. If Amaru gets killed by a stray round, Operation Kingslayer will be dead in the water before it even starts. Let's go.
Okay, can we open this, please? Open. Let's go, Amaru.
Are you Amaru?
What's left of him anyway?
Come on, I'm getting you out of here.
And we will go ahead and tag this on our way out the door because we're hopping in a helicopter.
I got it. I'll fly.
Yeah, so this is something I'm not really professional with. Release shift while using ARD to perform a quick turn. Shift to throttle up, control to throttle down. Whatever, we'll figure it out on the fly, right? How hard could it be? It's just a helicopter. Alright, so we're taking Amaru to Itakua Echo. Hey, everybody staying dry in there? You guys doing alright? Good, yeah. Yep, I'm glad to hear it. No, Amaru, don't touch my leg like that. Alright, everybody, we're coming in on Itakua Echo, and this thing crashes pretty quickly. If you just hold the control button down, you are going to plummet. Look at that. Yeah. This is our little rally point. I'm gonna go ahead and park this bad boy right over here by the dumpsters. I don't think anybody will notice, right? Woo! Okay. A little bit of a touch and go. And we're settled down. Everybody out.
Hold on.
And extract him.
Are you hurt?
Santa Blanca is not the most gracious of hosts. These Aucas, these demons, they had questioning me. Let us say, their talk of love was enough to make me vomit. But their methods were not...
Were their names Yuri and Polito?
Si. Yuri Polito.
These are the fucks that tortured Ricky Sandoval while Sueño questioned him. I want them bad.
We only saw run-of-the-mill Sicarios when we freed Amaru.
But I haven't seen Yuri and Polito in at least 3 days, maybe 4. I don't know where they are now.
We need more intel.
We'll search every village and camp until we find something.
Somebody's gotta know something. Gather documents, hack computers, interrogate hostile lieutenants, talk to civvies, whatever it takes.
We'll turn over every rock.
Man, those two seem like a couple of mean mamma jammas. All right, guys, this is going to be where I cut the episode. Oh, hold on. Yep. Let's open up the skills menu first. We're going to see what kind of support we have. Drone? No. Extra sync shot. Because taking down enemies in a orderly fashion, that's where you really begin to strive. Let's check out this video now. This is the new one. Here we go.
There were four people in the room the night DEA agent Ricky Sandoval was murdered. El Sueño, the head of the Santa Blanca cartel, Ricky, and the last two were La Yuri and El Polito. Yuri and Polito met at a poor state-run hospital in Chiapas, where El Polito was doing his residency and La Yuri worked as a nurse. It was love at first sight. From the first moment their eyes met, they were inseparable. A love like no other. One day, a Buchan named La Plaga walked into the ER, all shot up. It was touch and go for a while, but Yuri and Polito were able to save his life. La Plaga was grateful. He showered them with gifts, invitations to the most exclusive parties, even a new car. And after a while, La Plaga made Yuri and Polito the personal medical staff of the Santa Blanca cartel. But that wasn't their main job. See, Yuri and Polito know about the human body. They know how much pain a person can endure before he'll die. They know how to keep a person alive and awake so they can feel the pain. And most of all, they know how to inflict that pain. That's what they do in Itaqua province. When Santa Blanca captures someone that refuses to talk, La Yuri and El Polito make them talk. They break people. Like I said, there were four people in the room the night Ricky Sandoval was murdered. Sueño, Ricky, Yuri, and Polito. They kept Ricky alive while Sueño tortured him. Non-stop for 47 hours straight. They broke Ricky Sandoval. Then Sueño executed him.
Man, that's an ugly couple. But, oh wait a minute, do we have another skill that we can get? What? Okay, so, let's go ahead and get that. We'll get the stable aim. Wasn't planning on that.
Part of Santa Blanca security.
Stock
operation.
Up on our.
Remember to check out Bowman's briefing on the chain of command.
Our ammunition, and we will cut this episode right there for now, guys. If you like this episode, be sure to hit that thumbs up button. Be sure to leave me a comment in the section below. All right. If you like the way I'm editing this video and putting it all together, please make sure you mention that because I'm not sure how to structure these just yet.
We find the intel. We track them down.
You guys know that this is not a typical game for my channel. This is the first-person shooter that I've ever done, and I'm loving this game. It's intense. And I think you guys will enjoy it as well. So if you do, hit that thumbs up. If you don't, well, that's unfortunate, guys. Everybody stay happy, stay healthy. This is LCG, and I am heading out.